Hey, rich kids. Today in our story, Daniel has a dream about, and these weird creatures appear. We are going to make weird creatures.
Okay, so the girls have already put their eyeball. If you don't have googly eyes, you can just draw an eyeball. And then your mom or dad can get some paint. So we just use regular paint. And you mix some water with it. And you use an eyedropper or a baster, like what I have. And you put some paint on the page. And then you use a straw, like Katrina. And you can move the paint and make a crazy creature. See what you can make. And Maddie. I might need some more paint. And the crazier the better. And so Katrina's drawing some arms and some legs. You can add whatever you want to your crazy creature.
It looks like it has a big brain.
He's a smart one because he's got a big brain. And if you want to send us a picture of your crazy creature, we'd love to see it. And Maddie, what are we going to do next? Maddie.
We are going to sing our praises to God.
Because He is in control of every creature on the planet.
Cow.
give thanks in everything. 1 Thessalonians 5, 17 through 18. Today, let's keep praising God in our prayers. So I'm gonna say some things that I think are great about God, and then you tell God how great He is, whatever's on your heart, okay? God, you are so good. Thank you for being good to us. And God, you are so big. You created the world. You are so creative. We love this world that you created for us. Now it's your turn. God, you deserve all of our praise. We love you. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Good job. You know, we can't see God because He doesn't have a body like we do. But we can hear God. He gave us the Bible, and that's how He often speaks to us. So that's why we should read the Bible every day so that we can hear from God. Today, our lesson is about Daniel. Let's watch our video and see what Daniel learns about God today.
Hi friends, I'm Megan.
And I'm Jesse. Hey Megan, do you remember me telling you about the dream I had where I was swimming in a bowl of gravy?
Yes. How could I forget?
Well, last night I had another crazy dream.
Really? Tell me about it.
I dreamed that I was swimming again, but it wasn't water I was swimming in, and it wasn't gravy. It was guacamole, and you were with me. You were riding on a tortilla chip like it was a motorcycle and looking for the salsa.
Wow. That is a crazy dream, Jesse. Well, do you remember our Bible story about a dream King Nebuchadnezzar had?
Ah, yes, King Nebuchadnezzar.
King Nebuchadnezzar, never mind. Today's Bible story is about a dream that Daniel had.
Oh, good. I can say the name Daniel.
Yes, you can. Listen to the story.
When Belshazzar was the king of Babylon, Daniel had a strange dream. This dream was a message from God. In the dream, Daniel saw four big creatures come up from the sea. Each was different from the others. The first creature was like a lion. It also had wings like an eagle. The second creature was like a bear. It had three ribs in its mouth. The third creature was like a leopard. It also had four wings on its back and four heads. The fourth creature was strong and scary. It had large teeth and destroyed everything in its way. It also had 10 horns. Then Daniel saw a place in heaven with thrones. God sat down on a throne to judge the creatures. His hair and clothing were white like snow, and his throne was like fire. God let the first three creatures live for a short time, but the creature with horns was killed. Suddenly, God's son came. God gave him power to rule over everything. He was the king, and people from every nation and language served him. His kingdom would last forever. It would never be destroyed. Daniel was frightened by the dream. But God told Daniel what the dreams meant. The four creatures were four kings on earth. They would rule for a time, but then God would give his people the kingdom forever and ever. Daniel did not tell anyone about his dream, but he wrote down everything he saw. Jesus is king over everything. God lets people rule for a short time, but one day, Jesus will come back and set up his perfect kingdom. Everyone who trusts in Jesus will be in his kingdom, and it will last forever.
God used Daniel's dream to tell us something really important, that God is in control of everything, that even though some people will have power for a little while, Jesus is our King forever, and his power is over everyone. So if we are a follower of Jesus, we get to live in his perfect kingdom forever. Thank you, Jesus. Now let's answer some of these questions and see how well you understood our story today. And we'll see you here next time. Bye.
Thank you.